Hello and welcome to this course on quantum mechanics. My name is Henning Schumerus. I'm a professor for theoretical physics here at Lancaster University, where I arrived in 2005 and have taught this course almost without interruption ever since. Quantum mechanics is the most fundamental and arguably also the most interesting theory in physics, central to our understanding of the universe and a major subject and tool for contemporary research, including my own. In this video, I will give you an overview of the main goals and aims, as well as of the structure of this course. This will cover three main aspects. The first one is to develop the foundations of quantum mechanics, along with the mathematical language in which it is formulated. Here we have to learn how to describe the states of a quantum system, introduce observables that define which questions we can ask about such systems, understand how quantum systems change over time, and finally see how we can extract information by doing a measurement and how a system is affected by this. We will also go through a sequence of applications in which we will acquire a working knowledge of these concepts, first for simple one-dimensional systems and then in three dimensions, where we will in particular discuss the hydrogen atom. There we will also encounter angular momentum, as well as its generalization known as spin, which is an intrinsic property of fundamental particles. We will also learn about a very general method to describe complex quantum processes in terms of simpler ones, which is known as perturbation theory. And we will have a look at quantum mechanics for systems composed of many particles. Thirdly, on this way, we will encounter a range of quantum phenomena, such as the fact that for quantum systems, we generally deal with probabilities, which result in uncertainties of observables that also tell us how different observables are related to each other. Of course, also quantization, where observable properties take on discrete values, which not only occurs for energy, but for instance, also for angular momentum, and conceptually even deeper and more fascinating features such as entanglement. We will cover this material in the following sequence. First, I will introduce a couple of observations that help us to motivate the Schrödinger equation, which is the central equation of quantum mechanics. Then we will use this equation to describe simple one-dimensional systems, where we will already encounter energy quantization and see how position and momentum are interlinked in quantum mechanics. This puts us into a good position to introduce the four main postulates of quantum mechanics and discuss its mathematical language. To get some immediate practice with this language, we then have a first look at perturbation theory, resulting in a simple equation that tells us how the energies of a quantum system change when we modify some of its features. Next, we move on to three-dimensional systems. Here, angular momentum appears as a key observable, and its quantization suggests its generalization to spin, for which quantum mechanics indeed takes its simplest possible form. And all of this then helps us to calculate the quantized energies and orbitals of the hydrogen atom. We then consider the detailed dynamics of quantum systems, where we encounter transitions between states of different energy, and learn how to calculate the associated rates in time-dependent perturbation theory. We close this course by having a look at quantum systems involving many particles, which is the place where we will encounter entanglement. This also covers an area known as quantum statistics, which includes the phenomenon of black body radiation, the phenomenon which historically marked the birth of quantum mechanics when Max Planck came up with his first consistent theoretical explanation. At the end of this course, you will have obtained a solid understanding of the general features of quantum systems, how they are described both conceptually as well as mathematically, and how you can make predictions about them.